Hi, Trish. Thank you very much for taking time to talk to me on a Friday afternoon.
Thanks, Micaela. Happy to be here. Nowhere else to be on a Friday afternoon, I have to say. So.
That's true. That's true. Well, it's my good fortune that you've got time to talk to me. You're the executive director at WAM, Women and Mentoring, and you've been there for just over 2 years, 2.5 years.
That's right.
But you've got over 10 years of mentoring experience. And one of the things that has really come up through the alumni network that we have for a family violence intensive leadership program we run is an interest in mentoring. So I was really curious to talk to you a bit about some of your insights into mentoring and the value of it. You've got over 20 years experience in the sector, and you've also had experience as a volunteer, which was a bit of an introduction from what you say into the justice system.
That's right. Yeah, that was an interesting opportunity to volunteer with young people who were in contact with the police, being interviewed and being able to, I guess, help them understand their rights, but also make them feel comfortable whilst they were being interviewed and make sure their safety and their health was also paramount.
Yeah, so thank you for doing that. I think the people who volunteer their time to do roles like that are an incredibly important part of our community. So thank you for having done that on behalf of the community. Can you, Trish? Mentoring. Mm. Can you share a story of an experience you've had of a mentoring relationship and what you got out of it?
Absolutely. A couple of years ago, I was involved in a program called the Growth Project, where they have 10 charity leaders who are matched to 10 business leaders. And it's over the course of 12 months, you do a series of workshops, and it's about trying to build the capacity of those small not-for-profits so that they can, I guess, benefit from the corporate knowledge or corporate world, but at the same time, by rubbing shoulders with the corporate world, hopefully providing a bit of influence to them on what good we do in the world and how perhaps they could bring that into their own corporate sort of environment. And I was matched to a wonderful woman called Vicky Ward, who was a senior executive at the Commonwealth Bank. And at that time, they were going through the Royal Commission into banking. So I think for Vicky, it was an opportunity to, I guess, be reminded of what good things do happen in the world. And, you know, she needed that outlet at the same time as, you know, her bank was going through that Royal Commission. And for me, I got a lot out of it, just being exposed to someone who had a different way of doing things. Like from the not-for-profit sector, you're pitching for funding, you have a certain way of doing things. And to actually have an understanding of what people on the other end, the message they want to receive was actually important for me. And I kind of liken mentoring to my stories. You know your way to your toilet in the middle of the night. You know, you don't even have to turn the lights on. Make your way around the corner to the bathroom. Yeah. You might stub your toe on the couch or whatnot, but you kind of know which way you're going. The mentoring relationship with someone who helps you turn the lights on and perhaps find a different path to where you need to go, because you might have not have looked at those pathways before. Is that's a terrible analogy, but that's how I sort of see it. Someone who holds the light up for you and go, have you tried this way? Or what about that way? You know, there's actually other ways of doing something. So that's how I sort of, you know, describe a mentoring relationship. Someone who just shows you other ways of getting to where you want to go and hopefully not stubbing your toe along the way. Vicky actually was still in touch. Our program finished a year ago and we're still in touch. And I think Vicky was so impacted by our work at Women in Mentoring that she's actually become one of our volunteer mentors and was matched not that long ago to her participant.
That's fantastic. That's a nice story and it's a nice sharing. I think mentoring is a generous sharing relationship and it's nice that it's had that journey for the two of you.
Yes.
You talked about what mentoring is. And one of the things that you just talked about was the questions, someone asking questions and shining a light. What's a great question you've been asked in a mentoring relationship?
Yeah. Why I do what I do or what do I stand for? Particularly for myself, having worked in the not-for-profit sector for nearly 25 years, I have always wanted to do good, you know, and never really sort of challenged myself on that. I'm doing a good thing. I work for a charity, you know, just terrible. But at the same time, never really questioned my values or why I do this work or really what is my driving purpose. And part of the Growth Project and even part of Vicky's role was to challenge my values or question my values or actually ask me, what do I stand for? And I guess for me, trying to unpack that a little bit more so I would have a little bit perhaps more intensity or more passion about my work, but also more alignment with my values and my work, trying to articulate that was actually a hard task for me because it was trying to work out what it is about, particularly mentoring, because I'm actually very passionate about mentoring about how this relationship that is so simple can actually have such a profound effect on someone. And it's both ways. It's not just one directional, yes. You know, and I think that's why I'm very passionate about mentoring. But at the same time, it's one of the opportunities of getting to work at Women in Mentoring was actually trying to help women. And it's actually you're seeing women helping women and providing that support and utilising their social capital to help women who don't have that or don't have the capacity to navigate systems or just needing that moral support or you know, practical assistance. So I think for me, it's trying to find that equity. And that's what I had to unpack for myself was, you know, why do I do this? And it's not because I want to feel good or want to pat myself on the back, but it's because I actually really feel strongly about providing equity for people, an equitable sort of system or, you know, social structure. It's helping shift that balance so people who have got more opportunity can leverage that to help those that don't.
So talk to us a little bit about what mentoring means at WAM. It's great to hear your passion for your work.
So mentoring at WAM, it's really interesting because we get referrals for women who are in contact with the justice system, but it could be at different points of their contact, some in that early stage of contact at risk of offending or just about to go to court, but also women who have been through the system. Interesting enough, today I was having a conversation with a women's prison about women who are exiting prison and some of them trying to integrate back into their homes and or their home life in their town or this, you know, their suburb, and just not having people that they can connect with who can help them do that, or even going back into family and trying to, I guess, find their feet and not feel shame about what their behaviour has led them to do or led them into. So I guess for us, it's working with those women at all times on that spectrum of their contact with the justice system, but actually helping them find their own voice, helping them find their own way, you know, and helping them achieve their goals in their life. And the mentor really is just the person who is beside them, holding up that light perhaps and saying, well, there's actually other options. Do you want to try these? Ultimately, it's the woman's choice. You know, the participant gets to choose how she has her life, but the mentor is there to sort of actually help us see what other alternatives are out there, help her make better choices, hopefully, and hopefully have a better life.
Yeah, and ask some great questions.
Absolutely. That's it. It's challenging, gently challenging some of those behaviours and those choices that they make so that hopefully they can sort of start to, you know, whether it's problem solving, it's critical thinking, it's just them also making better choices along the way because someone's sort of asked them to think about why they make a certain choice or what do they think will happen if they do this. And that's also the beauty of that trusting relationship that they develop over time as well.
Yeah, a lot of the conversations I've had talking about mentoring, that trusting relationship is a really core part of it.
Absolutely.
Thanks so much for your time today, Tricia. We'll put some information about WAM in our newsletter for anybody who's interested in finding out more about your work, getting involved or supporting you in some way. So thanks heaps for your time today.
Excellent. Thanks, Micaela.